A big thanks to all of my Patreon supporters, and a big thanks to all of these donators of $5 or more. Brian D0313, Dead Zergling, Radio Raptor, and Vlad Tepish 3176. You all helped make these episodes possible. Howdy, Insufferable Gaming fans. Your old pal Rosser here with some more Battletoads. Last time, we beat Surf City, and we entered, I want to say, the Carnath Pit. That sounds about right. So we will be dealing with large snakes moving quickly, and hoping for the best. Now, I didn't get a chance to play last week because I was having some computer problems, so we'll just see how things go. Hopefully, I'll be able to figure out how to best get through this. We shall see. Uh-oh. There's the exit. So that was the easy one. That was the no-stakes one. But in here, we have spikes. Which means I will have to figure out how to dodge the spikes. Which, if you're familiar with my previous efforts, you'll know that I'm not exactly great at that. Especially if that keeps happening. So snakes are long critters, so I probably don't have to stay right next to the head. Indeed, I did not. Uh-oh, better drop. Oh, nope. Bah! Okay, there's a spike there. I can deal with this. I don't have too many continues today. I've just got a couple. But I'll do the best I can with what I got. I even saw that spike before, didn't I? Alright, what comes next? That is... oh! A danger to everyone. So I need to double jump on that one. That's gonna be a little trickier. I can handle this. He said, knowing full well that it would take him several tries. I do love trying to fool myself. Okay. Jump. Do the waiting game here. And then this one has a double jump. Triple jump. Fair enough, okay. Well, now we know what that one's gonna do, sorta kinda. This is a game much of memorization. So, if you can't memorize everything this level has to offer in three lives and three continues, you're going back. Going back again. So, hope you like going back again. Okay. Handle this. And... good. Next. This is a long one. Whoa! Easy there, killer. Okay. Oh, we start off with a bang on this one. Alright, what's this one doing? And there is a spike down there. Well, that was a quick excursion. Arnath's Lair, the Snake Pit. I'll keep trying. Oh yes, yes I will. Not much to say that hasn't already been said of this particular room. Really, what can you say other than ride the snake? to me tangos, right the snake. Now, let's see if I've immediately forgotten everything about this level. Which, clearly, I have. Always a bonus. Always a delight. I think there's another warp somewhere in this level, but it's gonna be a long damn time before I figure that out. Jumpy. Yep. That time we got it. You gotta kinda jump in order to, catch the, part of the snake you can climb. You can't just walk up into it and climb it. For whatever reason. There we go. There we go. Oh, oh, and then the fast one, right? Oop. Okay. Now, they start us off tricky. Very tricky. Uh-oh. This could be... Nope, we good. Alright. So, where's the next one? There we are. What are you gonna do? Mr. Snicks. Yes, we have a interesting thing what needs crawling through there. Or precision jumping, I should say. We all know how great I am at precision jumping, right? Aha, got it. Now what? Okay. That was, danger-esque. Damn. Every time I learn something new. Sometimes to my satisfaction, other times not so much. I'm pretty sure there's at least one more room after this, maybe two. Two rooms full of these dangerous-ass snakes. Aha, got it. Alright. Wait for this one. Then I have to do some jumping. Oh, crap. Alright. Where am I going? What am I looking at? Okay. Ah! Jeez! Thanks, game. Really appreciate that one. By which I mean I don't appreciate that at all. I wasn't too friendly. This is gonna be painful, isn't it? And we're back at the start of the level. Oh, I can run in this level. Not sure exactly why I need to, but there we have it. Alright, come back, snake. Snake surfing! Radical! Hang toad! Etc. The etc. is the one that really gets you. Are we... Whoa! Shite! Well, I'm crapping this one up. Let's try not to screw up the easiest one this time. That'd be great. Can you even get any points in this level? Do you just get them when you go out the door or what? Okay, I made it onto the snake. That's nice. Always a plus. Yep, did get some points for that. Well, I think it's safe to say I won't be finding a 1-up due to lots of points on this stage. But maybe I can get lucky and just find one that's sitting around somewhere. Because I need all the help I can get with this. Why not? Clearly I do. Jump enough that time. Sometimes you jump too much. Sometimes you jump not enough. It's very precision-based. I got confused. It really showed there. This level's going to make me miserable for at least a whole other episode, isn't it? This level's not so bad. It gets a whole lot worse, believe me. If you're not familiar with this game, I assure you. This level is going to be a refreshing walk in the park compared to what comes later. True story. Right. This is the long one, and then we get the fast one. Quick snick. Carry me home! Hi-ho, snake, silver. Etc. Oh, not a good... There we go. Okay, now the hard one with the precise jumping. Frack! I hate that one. I really hate that one. Shouldn't be that difficult, probably, but for me, it is. Well, this will give me a chance to practice earlier levels again, at least. Okay. Walk on this one till it gets back around. Try not to screw up. And then... Aw, man. That was it. That was game over. Yeah. Well, we're gonna have to start over again. Might as well get to it, right? Yeah. Maybe I will try my best to hit all the warps on the way. That'd be a pain in the ass if I missed the warps and had to go through all the levels. Although, it would give me a chance to get some 1-ups. Okay, got that one. Now is the tricky one, the one in the turbo tunnel. Is that a tits joke? That might have been a tits joke. No. Wait, it wasn't. Okay, never mind. False alarm. I get it now. She's implying that the Battletoads are boobies, and that they outsmarted her booby traps. Not her impressive rack. Because that would have just been inappropriate. Right? Right. Kick the rat! That old rat is a mean motherfucker, gonna kick him on down the line. Yup. And... one more. Now, since it's been at least 2 weeks since I've even touched a turbo tunnel, I wonder if I'm going to screw this up horrifically. Also, I have to hit the warp. Otherwise, I'll be going through the ice cave. And I am by no means competent at the ice cave, either. Whoa. These early ones always trip me up a little. Ah, Concentrate. Oh, shit. Well, it had to happen eventually, right? I'll know what to expect next time. Be nice if I wouldn't keep falling for that the first time every time, though. Every time, man. Like it never fails. Okay. Now things are getting tricky. I thought for sure that was gonna get me. Talk about an adrenaline rush. Should be hitting a one-up pretty soon, though. Any second now. There we go. That's my one-up. That'll make up for that one I missed. As long as I don't miss any more in the immediate future. But when has that ever happened, right? Whee! Okay. We all know what's coming up now. Alright. Yes! Made it. I almost missed it, but then I didn't. Whew. But I only barely got through this level last time, so this might not go great. Let's take a second to breathe. Drink a little bit of ice water. I'm gonna need that ice water. Flowing through my veins! I can never remember how to get past that one. Not like that. Ah, got the one up. Excellent. Now the whirlpools, which are another matter entirely. Oh no! Well, I made it pretty far until the inevitable screw up there. Don't mess this up. You lose, you're out of the family. I lost. I'm out of the family. But I got the one up, so that's the important thing. If I can consistently get the one up, you know. That helps. Ah, frickin' whirlpools. Give me those points. If I can consistently get the one up, you know, that means that I will be able to... Well, so much for that theory. I was gonna say build up my extra lives by getting lots of points. But now I've got to memorize this level again, which I hadn't done in the first place, and not gonna get any easier this time, I don't think. Alright, full health this time going into the whirlpools. That's good, right? Good, good, good. Okay. Now, gotta deal with Big Blag and the Tall Walkers. And these nutsacks. In face of little douches. I gotta be careful not to knock my weapon off the screen here. That would really give me a bad time. Now just focus on beating the boss. And then the mine section. Which I have got no practice on. I just beat it out of pure reflex of luck last time. Thanks for not letting me get those flies there, buddy. Alright. play this very safe. That's what I need to do. Easier said than done. I'll do it the slow way. That's fine. If that means, you know, not losing lives that I need. That started out a little rough. Easier said than done. I thought I could juggle him for a minute there. That would have been good. Keeping him next to the... Well, I think we've got a new method of hitting him, so that's cool. Alright, even got a 1-up. Now for the second part, which I am a little less confident about. I don't know if it's random or what. I have no idea. I do know that these things will be coming pretty fast. Indeed they are. Ah, there's another one up there. I wish I'd known about that a little sooner. Another one perhaps? Nope. Oh well. Okay, that wasn't too difficult. So, we've gotten to the snake pit with more lives than I had going in the first time. This is good. So, it didn't take us long to get back here as I expected. If I didn't know any better, I'd say I was getting competent at this. That's only because we're still in the early levels. This is technically like the halfway point, I think. Maybe less. Yeah, actually I think it's a little less than halfway. So if that tells you anything about how the effort's gonna have to ramp up, it should. Especially now that we're back to the part where I make mistakes and they get me killed. That was the only mistake I can afford to make in, from here on out with these guys. Everything else will kill me a bit. Just a little bit. Impaled on spikes. Hell of a way to go, I would assume. I've never been impaled on spikes before. I've had some pretty huge-ass splinters, but that's about it. Had one go all the way through the webbing of my thumb and forefinger one time. Had to yank it out with pliers and get back to work. Because I was working the chop saw, and I was the only person in the whole damn plant keeping things on schedule. I was a bottleneck. And the only thing worse than having to do all that shit by myself was when they'd send someone incompetent to help me. Why they couldn't just order enough parts in the first place, instead of having me cut them from other parts that we still technically needed to finish the orders, I'll never know. But, you know, they didn't let me run the place, unfortunately. If they had, they might not have gone out of business. Oh shit, this is bad. What? 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 Well, I got a little farther that time, so we're still, you know, making progress, technically. Technicles. That's my ancient Greek name. Technicles. Big jump there seems to, like, actually be what you need to do. Which is weird. But, you know, whatever works. And this bastard. Oh, another one of these, eh? Shit! A little farther, a little farther, a little farther. So the second one didn't have any spike to it, which is nice. It's nice to have a break from constant spikes. Ruining my day. Whoa, that was almost a mistake. Okay. What do I do here again? Right. Play the waiting game. And then the fast one. And then another fast one. Another fast one after that, perhaps? Sure, why not? Yay, I made it! Okay. Now, here's a question. Is this a safe spot? Or am I eventually going to get killed? Can't climb up on that. I think I'm gonna have to wait for that first one to come back and make a, like, giant leap for it. If I had any idea where it was. Surely it'll come back, right? Sounds like there are a lot of snakes on this one. Do they not cycle back through? This is making me very nervous. Alright, fine. Ah! Bugger. No! Don't do it! This frickin' level. Gotta get back there again. Gonna bust your beak, buddy. Let's see you do it, says I. You got wings, you could hover over this crap. I mean, come on. Why don't you invent something that makes controlling these snakes a little easier? Like a taser. A snake taser. A snazer. Yes, the snazer. Sold wherever fine animal punishing products are sold. So, pretty much nowhere. You can buy specific bullets to take out snakes. I always keep a few of those around. They're a little expensive, though, so you don't want to just use them as a matter of course. They're like little shotgun bullets for your pistol. They're kind of cool. I imagine they'd be really hard on the bore of your firearm, though, if you use them very much. Can I do this on the first shot this time? Oh, I can't wait to find out. Will he do it? Will he do it? Will he make it? Will he rise? Will he fall? He fell. Well. Gandalf, I ain't. And frogging it. Frogging and hot dogging. There we go. That jump just always makes me very nervous. And it always will. And we just wait. And the fast one, then another fast one. And then a fast one with a spike. Two sets of spikes. So close I was. Oh, I should pay a little closer attention to what I am actually doing. This is a game of inches. What the hell was that? I was climbing backwards up a moving snake. Duh-huh. You know, happens all the time. What's so weird about that? Damn it! Okay, I guess I gotta pull the reins back on that second jump there. Thanks for, helping me out with that one, game. Game Gar. One of these days, I'll get the hang of this. Doesn't look like it's gonna be today. Things are looking a little sketchy. Shut up. Okay. This might be my last continue. Find out. I'd at least like to get to the final chamber. You know, maybe past the first jump in the final chamber, just so I can start practicing that one. Clearly, Battletoads, the game, disagrees with what I want to do. It's like, nope, not gonna let you do it. Not gonna let you do it. And I'm like, well, fine. I'll just get good. Then you won't be able to stop me now, will you? You mean old mistreating snakes? You no-count soypants? I'll have the last laugh. Ha ha ha! Maybe not today. Maybe not next week, but eventually. The day will be mine. The day was not mine. So much trial and error. Mostly error. How about trial and victory? That'd be a little too much to ask for? You know, if I could make fewer errors, the trials wouldn't last quite as long. We could all move on with our lives. Okay. Bye. Try not to screw this up. Try real hard. Zoop. Right on in. Okay. This is where I have the troubles. So many troubles. The uncomfortably blue chamber of death. Who means death? Who knew? Let's see if I can avoid climbing backwards on a snake this time. Alright. Don't screw up. Don't screw up. Don't screw up. Screw this up. There we go. Alright. Now this chamber, which I don't know what I'm doing, and I've missed my ride. Ah, but now I can see when the snake comes back. So when it comes back, I should actually be able to hop on it and then climb it up. Ah, I thought I could get on that. Actually, it's for the best that I didn't, because that would have been kind of a disaster. Just waiting for my ride. It'll be here any second now. Any second now. Any second now. I hear things occurring elsewhere in the level. Aha! See? There's still snakes moving about. It's gonna be a long-ass chamber to learn, isn't it? I can tell. If it goes this long before the cycle finishes, I can only imagine what it's going to be like later in the level. Bulls. Okay, made it that time. Damn it! How the hell am I supposed to handle that nonsense? With skill and aplomb. That's how. I couldn't frickin' jump in time. Well, at least I still have one more continue, so that's nice. Of course, I've got to spin that continue in the snake pit, so that's less nice. Oh no, you don't. That's what I thought. Run for it! Flap them flippy floppy feet. Just frog legs, kicking it and kicking it. And out. Do not screw this up, me. Can't afford another mistake. Which is hilarious considering my complete lack of knowledge about how the last chamber is executed. Executed is the right word for it, too. Because that's how that's what it was like. I got freaking executed on that one. There's a reason people say this game is hard. And no one's ever argued with any of them that said that. No one's been like, nah, Battletoads is a piece of cake. No one says it. I don't think anyone ever will. Well, you know, speedrunners would think it was easy after they've practiced it approximately 80 billion times. But I have not played this 80 billion times. I played this like 8 times, give or take. I don't know what the exact number is. I'll have to check the episode number. You know, aside from the few times I played them as a kid, but, you know, those all ended at the Turbo Tunnel, so they don't really quite count the same. Okay, nailed that one. Now, the tricky part. Well, let's face it, most of them are tricky parts. Jump this time? Didn't quite nail it. Now I'm gonna have to wait. Which is bad, because it's a long-ass wait. Well, these things happen. you're gonna do, right? When I see one come down the other side, we'll know I'm almost ready to jump. Okay, should be soon. I should probably not punch myself into the spikes. Alright, get to try this again. This is gonna take some precision-ass timing. Aha! Ah! Okay, that one goes up around the spikes. I did not know that. Okay, and that one was a jump up. A Johnny jump up. I don't know where I'm going, okay? Well, how could I have possibly known about that, you might ask? The answer is, I couldn't have. Not reasonably. That snake there is some nerve-wracking. Okay. Now, how do I do this? Do I have to wait for it to come back around? Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da No S easy. I'm getting there. Right. It does that. Let's try to remember that. This game does everything it can to make absolutely sure you don't get muscle memory on these levels. Because every time you learn something easily, the next thing you have to do the opposite. Oh, so much for that one. Well, we made progress. Not great progress, but progress nonetheless, so we'll call this episode a victory. And hopefully next time we can get past the snake pit. But until then, thanks for watching. This has been your old pal Rosser. Take a drink.